A man who was arrested at the ongoing protests in Portland was released. The charges were dropped. They said that he was interfering with a police officer's duties and ultimately just cut him loose because that's what the DA's been doing. And now we have the tragic results of the failure of the DA to actually uphold the law. Suspect arrested at protest 1 week before deadly stabbing. This guy was arrested and they cut him loose and then he killed two people. Now, I was talking about the guy who got shot in Portland, and the man who was accused of doing that also had been arrested previously on an illegal gun charge. And in that regard, I said, you know, because I believe it was months prior. You know, I don't know if we're going to we've got a Second Amendment argument. The real issue for me is that the man is a murderer. But it is fair to say if the guy was actually held to the standard set by the Democrats in these cities, these deaths would not have happened, or this particular death in Portland. And I think it's fair to say this is a recurring problem when you have a district attorney who's like, yeah, you know, if you're going to interfere or assault the cop, I'm going to cut you loose and let you go. And the guy gets out and these people are unwell. They're unhinged. They're dangerous and they're murderous. In Portland, they have laws. They've agreed on these laws. They've decided based on who they've voted for and what they've passed, city council and the state level, these people should go to jail. But then you get a far leftist who brings a gun and they say, yeah, you know, this guy, nah, he's good. We won't uphold the law for him. But heaven forbid a Trump supporter was walking around armed. They'd lock that guy up and throw away the key forever. Heaven forbid a pro-Trump guy was walking around at a protest, engaging in some kind of protest civil disobedience. They arrested him or interfering with a cop. They would throw the book at these guys. I really do believe it. The far left gets a pass, and it results in people dying. We got major breaking news, though. The federal government, the feds have deputized Oregon State Police. This is huge. They're going to be bypassing the local district attorney. And now, when people get arrested, it would seem this is where they're going. The state police make an arrest of you engaging in this violent behavior and dangerous behavior, criminal activity, throwing Molotovs, whatever. The feds are coming for you now, and the feds aren't playing around. This is the point about Donald Trump and the fear of a Joe Biden presidency. Would Joe Biden's DHS have deputized state police to stop this madness? You know what, man? I would never put money on that. You could tell me that if I put down $1 and then Joe Biden does pull it off, it's 1,000 to 1. You win $1,000. I'd say no. I mean, honestly, I'd probably be like, fine, it's a dollar. But the point I'm trying to make is I know I have the dollar. There's nothing that's going to convince me that Joe Biden would actually send in DHS. He's going to be like, oh, well, you know, we got to let the locals take care of things and, you know. The Democrats in all these cities and states are the ones who are refusing to hold these people accountable. Why would I imagine that Joe Biden in the presidency would hold them accountable? He would not. Donald Trump is actually found a way to go after these people without invoking the Insurrection Act. And I got to say, I'm impressed. I really am. I really am happy to hear it. There was a plan put forth by the Oregon governor. She said all these things are going to happen. We're going to bring in the police. We're going to bring in the FBI. Local outside police. A local sheriff said, you never asked me to do this. And no, I'm not sending in my people when you refuse to prosecute. Case in point, these two young people have lost their lives. So Trump has found that way. The feds will do it. The feds will take care of it. OSP, Oregon State Police, hereby deputized. I want to read a little bit of this first. And I know it's a sad story, so I'm just going to give you the general details. This is what happens when they refuse to uphold the law. This is what happens when you have morality policing, okay? When the district attorney says our ideological allies are free to go, they end up killing people. They end up committing more crimes. This is from KOIN6. They say a man accused of stabbing two people to death in Northeast Portland in June was arrested at a protest in downtown Portland just 1 week prior. Cassie Leighton, 22, and Najav Hobbs, 39, were stabbed on June 16th near Northeast David Street. Police arrested Philip Lawrence Nelson, 39, 2 days later. He faces two murder charges and is being held without bail. Yet now they'll hold him. Just days before, he allegedly killed Leighton and Hobbs, though. Nelson was taken into custody at a protest in downtown Portland. Court records show he was arrested on charges of interfering with a peace officer. Those charges were dismissed the next day. Before that, Nelson did not appear to have any criminal history in Oregon. Nelson told authorities he had been homeless, living in the Portland area, for the 2 months before the crime, according to court records for the murder arrest. A few days, just a few days later, he killed two people. They could have said, you've interfered with an officer and we're going to hold you and you'll see a judge. And these people would still be alive. And that's the problem. DHS tells Portland Democratic mayor to prioritize public safety or feds will intervene. Acting DHS Secretary Chad Wolf says, Portland Mayor Ted Wheeler has passively stood by during months of riots that are destroying the city. From Just the News. The violence, mostly at night, has resulted in deaths recently of three people and has included clashes between pro-Trump groups and far-left demonstrators. According to a letter Monday from Wolf to Wheeler, the Department of Homeland Security has made 255 arrests and declared 23 instances of riots and unlawful assemblies during the past month alone. He also wrote that Wheeler has, amid the chaos, stood passively by, arguing that nightly violence will ultimately burn itself out. The evidence demonstrates otherwise. Oh, you betcha. Ted Wheeler's now saying he's moving from his condo because they tried to burn it down the other day. Yeah, 3 months of these people being cut loose every single day, and you'd think they'd have learned their lesson. On Friday, Wheeler wrote a letter to President Trump rejecting federal assistance, which Trump has continually offered. On behalf of the city of Portland, no thanks. Portlanders are on to you. We've already seen your reckless disregard for human life. Yeah, it's real interesting. Coming from a man who runs a city where two people were just killed, or they were killed a couple months ago, by one of these extremists. And it could have been prevented. That's big words coming from a man who runs a city where a dude just executed a Trump supporter. At this point, Trump has a duty to protect his supporters. To be completely honest, to protect everybody. If the mayor's not going to do it, and two innocent people are now dead in an unrelated killing, but the guy could have been stopped, and a Trump supporter is dead, then yeah, the DHS is right. I don't know if this is true, but my understanding is that the feds could intervene in the event that the rights of citizens are not being upheld, not just the Insurrection Act. I don't know for sure, but it certainly seems like at this point, Trump should, you know, he could theoretically just walk in, but it looks like they found that way in. Wolf wrote in response, ignoring criminal behavior is no way to protect the citizens of your community, the same citizens who entrusted you to hold elected office. I urge you to prioritize public safety and to request federal assistance to restore law and order in Portland. Well, here's the hammer drop. This is from KOIN6. Oregon State Police troopers federally deputized amid renewed Portland protest response. Bravo, DHS. Bravo, U.S. Marshals. Bravo, Donald Trump. I really mean it. Trump supporter was targeted. He was killed. You want to talk about Kenosha? We'll talk about Kenosha. Should Rittenhouse have been there? There's a whole lot of questions about that. We can have an argument. We can say the whole thing shouldn't have happened. Nobody should have been out past curfew. This story is a guy walking down the street. They're behind him and they yell. He turns around. They have a gun. He reaches with what appears to be mace of some sort and he gets shot twice in the chest. Not self-defense. And then the far leftist guy who was accused of this, we believe it's a far leftist guy, runs, flees, targeted them, shot them, and fled. And what has the Portland mayor done? Complained about Trump. Has he kept his city safe? Quite the opposite. The people who live in his building are panicked. And now Portland mayor says he'll move. Is that the best you can do? You'll move? They tried to burn the building down. Send in the police, arrest these people, and lock them up. They're violent. They're attempting to kill people. You even said it, Ted Wheeler. You said when they blocked the entrance and exits to the police department, tried to burn it down, it was attempted murder. And this is the best you'll do. I'll move. Everyone, the left and the right, are both calling for this guy to resign. Let's get to the news. Oregon State Police troopers responding to the ongoing protest-related unrest in Portland have been federally deputized, state police confirm. State police tell KOIN6 they're working with the U.S. Attorney's Office to review arrests made by troopers assigned to Portland for potential prosecution. The troopers assigned to Portland have been cross-deputized by U.S. Marshals. Oh, you love to see it. You get arrested by these guys now? Oh, don't worry. That Mike Schmidt guy who said he's not gonna charge people, doesn't matter anymore. It's going to the feds. And you want to try and burn a building down and kill people, which they're still doing. Well, now you get to go to a federal prison. Good. Somebody's finally doing something about it. And this is why I'm saying straight up, they try and blame Trump for the violence. Trump's the only one who's trying to stop it. What has Joe Biden done? His staff helped fund bailouts for these people. What has Kamala Harris done? Solicited donations to bail these people out. And now the funniest thing, when Joe Biden says, I challenge Donald Trump to condemn the violence. Dude's been condemning the violence the entire time, calling for law enforcement. And now he's taking action to do something. What do, Joe Biden? You hide in your basement, or you go out and give a speech to six people in a room. Can't even speak straight. They say, the Multnomah County District Attorney Mike Schmidt previously announced his office would presumptively decline to prosecute certain misdemeanor charges stemming from the protests, a move which resulted in criticism from law enforcement agencies, including state police in mid-August. Quote, OSP is not criticizing any officials, and we respect the authority of the Multnomah County District Attorney. But to meet the governor's charge of bringing violence to an end, we will use all lawful methods at our disposal, an Oregon State Police spokesperson said. You see, OSP was brought in to get the feds out. The left was complaining over and over again about Donald Trump having the PACT officers, CBP, ICE, Federal Protective Services and U.S. Marshals guarding the Multnomah County courthouse. The federal courthouse in Multnomah County. They said, we got to get the feds out of here. The feds are the ones, stoking the violence. And so finally, the governor announced the feds were withdrawing. Well, DHS said that's not true. We're just going to defer to the state police now. They brought in an outside police department, the state police, to police the riots. The state police retreated. They gave up. You know why? They said everyone we arrest is getting cut loose. And we know what happens when they do this. People are dead now. This may be one of the worst mayors we have ever seen in the history of our country. I say that because I don't have a history of mayors. I'm sure there's I was going to mention the dog mayor, but actually I think the dog mayor probably does a good job because he keeps everyone happy and he's like chill about it. You know those stories where like a small town will elect a dog to be their mayor or something. I'm pretty sure there's probably been like drunken, corrupt mayors. Fine. But this guy, I'm going to say, I think Ted Wheeler is corrupt, absolutely corrupt and spineless. He attacks Donald Trump while his own citizens are dying. And while he even acknowledges that the far left extremists are trying to kill people, and he still does nothing. Nothing. When they try to burn down his own building, what does he do? Runs. Runs and hides. That's it. That's the best thing he can do. Dude's super rich, apparently, too. They say it is unclear at this time whether all arrests made by deputized state police troopers will be prosecuted on a federal level, or if assaults or troopers at protests will result in charges of assault on a federal officer. KOIN 6 News has reached out for further clarification. In a statement, a spokesperson for Oregon Governor Kate Brown's office said some troopers were federally deputized earlier this summer in order to enter the Mark O. Hatfield Federal Courthouse, which had been the epicenter of protests for the first 2 months. They are committed to working with our community with the goal of protecting free speech, keeping the peace, and keeping people safe as they exercise their right to peacefully protest, the spokesperson said in a statement, adding, the U.S. Attorney and Multnomah County DA work together every day deciding which cases each will prosecute. The news of state police troopers being deputized by U.S. Marshals, which was first reported by freelance journalist Deborah Bloom, came a day after sheriffs from surrounding counties declined to send in deputies to help Multnomah County and the Portland Police Bureau after Governor Brown outlined a law enforcement plan to respond to the unrest. One person was shot and killed Saturday night near a pro-Trump caravan rally and counter protest in downtown Portland, bringing a renewed spotlight on the city that has seen more than 90 days of consecutive protests and hundreds of resulting arrests. Look at this video. This is a video, I can't play it, but it's from Andy Ngo. Happening now, Antifa Black Bloc militants surround the Seattle PD East precinct in the heart of the former Chaz and throw incendiary devices at the building. They recently barricaded the door with quick drying cement and set the building on fire. Yeah, they arrested a guy for that. These black-clad lunatic extremists are in a video lobbing Molotov cocktails. I believe they're incendiary devices, but they look like Molotovs, at the police building. And then once they get a good fire going, they all start running away in a crowd. How do you deal with this? Is this a criminal conspiracy? Is this an insurgency? These people are all wearing the same thing, and they're throwing dangerous weapons. They're using deadly weapons that could result in death. Well, I'll tell you what. Donald Trump has called the violence in Kenosha domestic terrorism. He's right. It needs to be said. It absolutely does. I know you've seen the videos. We've talked about this when they demand people bend the knee and salute. They'll argue that those are just the peaceful protests. Let me show you a headline from The New York Times. Journalist quits Kenosha paper in protest of its Jacob Blake rally coverage. Daniel Thompson, an editor at the Kenosha News, resigned over a headline that highlighted, here we go, a speaker who made a threat during a peaceful protest. Threats are not free speech. I believe threats of violence are actually crimes. It's an interesting point. They're saying the protest is peaceful because no one's doing anything, but the person said he was going to kill people. If you have a rally of people and you get up and say that you're going to go kill people, that's criminal. And I don't know if we can call that a peaceful protest. I don't know what you'd call it, though. It's an interesting conundrum, right? Let me ask you. You got peaceful protests where people are waving little flags and saying, you know, change the law and, you know, reform the police. And I'm like, here. And then you've got riots where people are like smashy, smashy, and they're running around burning things down. But what do you call it when you have a big rally of people and they're saying it's time to kill? It's not a peaceful protest. Is it like an insurgent rally? It's not particularly violent, but it's criminal. A criminal insurgent rally. I don't know what you call it. But this guy was upset because some dude stood up at a rally and said that because they killed one of theirs, they were going to kill some of theirs. And then what did we get? Dude in Portland got shot in the chest twice. This dude was upset by, he quit his job, whatever. Good. I mean, when I see this, he's mad and he's quitting. That's a good thing. That means these far left extremists are being weeded out of these newspapers and the media. Fine. But my question is, New York Times, is it a peaceful protest if they're threatening to kill people? I don't know. Is it a conspiracy at that point? Because think about it. This guy says he's going to do it. All these people cheer for it. And they're actively protesting, calling for protest. If these people then go engage in protest, is that not conspiracy to commit murder? Like, you know, this guy is going to go kill people. He said he's going to do it. And you go provide him crowd support. I don't know. I'll think about that one. Comment below and let me know what you think. But Trump has not. Trump's going straight for it. Domestic terror. I'll tell you what. When you have people at a rally and they're saying things like they will kill someone, they're telling all of the people of this city, many of these people, these extremists, don't actually live there. They're letting you know, if you do not do what we want, violence is coming your way. And people then get scared, get backed into a corner, and if they feel like they have no choice, they can't do anything. That's why the mayor of Portland may be one of the most dangerous individuals in politics right now, because you've got terrorists overrunning his city. He does nothing about it. He runs. They attack his condo. He runs. He refuses to do anything. He absolutely does. He just complains. And then he complains about Trump. Dude could even easily just be like, Trump, send him on in. Bring in the feds. Shut her down. He won't do that. So that's dangerous. He's allowing the extremists' ground to romp about and terrorize people. Well, you know what, man? Trump's not a fascist. That's just absurd. Trump is very much so in line with the presidents we've had. Some people have actually compared him to Bill Clinton in terms of policy and rhetoric. I'm not saying he's identical. I'm saying there are certain things about him that people liked that reminded them of Clinton in terms of policy issues. They say Trump is like where Democrats used to be. There are some problems there. I can understand why the Never Trumpers are freaking out, because Trump's a moderate. And the conservative, like the old school Never Trumpers, don't like that a moderate. And you know, Trump has his issues, has taken over the party. It's an insurgency. But Trump is doing things that the Democrats supported 10 years ago, not even 10 years ago. But they call him a fascist. Well, I'll tell you what, man. The feds have deputized these police, which is a good thing. And now we may actually see Trump take control of this. I mean, that's the smartest thing. I didn't even think of this. I can't believe I didn't even think about deputizing local, state police so that the feds can prosecute. It's brilliant. No insurrection act, no federal law enforcement, but the federal prosecutors can charge these people. That's brilliant. People have been saying insurrection act over and over again. It's like, whoa, wait a minute. I think Trump just figured it out, and I'm happy about it. And I think people are recognizing this, and they're going to vote for Trump in droves. But you know what worries me? The red mirage they're saying is going to happen. Oh, yeah, Trump's going to landslide on election night. But then once the mail-in ballots come in from various places over a week, Biden will win. That's going to be freaky, man. The Trump team just put out an ad. It's a clip, I should say. And it's Joe Biden. I have no idea what he's trying to say. He's like, can you imagine? It took 100 year. Look. And I'm just like, I don't know what you're saying, dude. And Trump said, does anybody really think like this guy should run the country or that this great USA should have this man as his leader? And I'm like, no, absolutely not. So here's the result. I think people are going to run to Trump because Trump's not all that bad. They lie about him in the media all day, every day, and people are starting to wake up. And when it came to the months of rioting, the reality is Trump is the only one who's actively solving this. They say this is Trump's America. That's what Joe Biden's trying to say. Okay. Yeah, in Trump's America, the feds deputized state police, and now they're coming for the extremists. They didn't have to interfere in local affairs. It's the local police still making the arrests as they see fit. He didn't have to invoke the Insurrection Act and send in the military or National Guard or anything like that. They solved the problem. Let's see if they can get the job done. But I'm impressed. I'll leave it there. Next segment's coming up at 1 p.m. on this channel. Thanks for hanging out, and I will see you all then.